Microsoft Planner has had a big update, and we're going to be overviewing what it does and what are the new improvements as part of the experience. It's available through Teams, and we're going to be exploring how it works and operates in this video. Today's video is kindly sponsored by Sunsama. Now, Sunsama is used by over 8,000 busy professionals, and it's a daily planner that I've even used in the past. It combines some really interesting features, like obviously daily planning, focus modes, unified work experiences, and just that general focus on mindfulness and work-life balance. They've got some newer features like AI planned time, which allows you to create a task and automatically suggest and assign a planned time for the task based on all of your previous tasks you created. So the more you use Sunsama, the better this gets. There's also a channel recommendation, which will save you time by automatically assigning channels for your tasks for you, which is perfect by using and learning what you've already done in Sunsama. So you can check out Sunsama below, and a big thanks to those guys for sponsoring this video. Hello folks, my name is Francesco. If you're interested, you can check out Toolfinder if you're in a hunt for any productivity tools. You can find it linked below and up here, and it will help you to provide you with insights, reviews, and lots more about productivity tools as you seek them for work and life. So let's dig into Microsoft Planner, and things have changed a little bit because the logo's changed. It, as you can see, the logo is a combination of to-do and also project in one, and it's trying to bring all of those experiences together, where it's trying to essentially help to not fragment the task management experience in Microsoft 365. Let's overview how this works. And there are a few changes, mainly because it's now got a focus on My Day, which is something we've seen inside of Microsoft To Do. And you can go ahead and create a task directly in here. For example, I could add one like record video and press enter. And as you can see, it's already been added to My Day because I'm already in My Day area. However, you can remove it from your day, as well as change the progress on this too. There are some Kanban abilities which we'll come to later, but largely this is helpful because I can put in progress and see a almost fully completed task in my system. I can give it a priority level like important, although there are only two priority levels, medium and important, and I can even give it a due date. For example, I could say maybe tomorrow, 5th of May. Or 1st of May, the 5th month of the year. And you can see here that it's got a source of the private tasks area, which are basically my tasks, and they appear inside of here. And if I go to my plans, you can start to see all of my projects I do have. Now, it's weird, they don't call them projects in here, they call them plans, and they do help you to organize them, and you can collaborate with other people. So if I want to, I can go up to the top right-hand corner here and click my plan, and you can choose from a range of options. Now, what you're probably wondering as you're watching this video, how do I get access to the new Microsoft Planner? Well, it's currently only available through Microsoft Teams, and you'll need to access the web version and go and make sure you have a Microsoft 365 plan that includes Planner. I think that's one of the lower rung pricings, about £5 per month. And you have to go to the apps area and go and find and install it. This will then appear on your left-hand side, and you can even right-click and pin it, which allow it to be available here. You can even move it up the rung and order there, which means you can access it alongside of Microsoft Teams. So as I was saying, the plans area is a little bit more extensive. It allows you to create these plans. You can start from basic plans, but if you have the Copilot or premium pricing in Microsoft Teams, it does allow you to get access to more abilities, which will extend your functions and allow you to do more with Microsoft Copilot. But here are some of the basic elements of it. If I wanted to start a project management area, it's going to help me create a board, chart, and a schedule view. But if I wanted to do, for example, software, it's going to come up with a different experience. And there's only a few options here. And as you can see, they're all limited to list, chart, board, and schedule layouts. So here in this case, I'm going to choose the simple plan. And as you can see, I can add a few people as part of the company, as well as add it to my pinned plans. So I'm going to go ahead and create that plan. And you'll see what appears is a nice Kanban-like board. And very much like Kanban experiences, you can organize it, move it across the right areas, and start adding more detail to the task. Here you can even assign it to somebody, and you can give it a label to indicate some for example, pink, but in this case, it could be something else like what type of work it is, like writing, and you can see what bucket it appears in. This resembles a lot of what GTD has, but you can also put it into the right bucket so that it's in the right area of the Kanban. So if I put this in progress, you can also start the progress of the task itself, which is quite helpful, as well as seeing the priority level. Now inside of the plans area, you can actually add more priority levels like urgent, important, medium, and low, which help give you four indication of priority levels. You can even set a start date and a due date, as well as repeating over here as well. Now you can also show this on card or not if you don't want the checklist items that appear here inside of the items. Now all of these little checklist items are not clickable. They do not create subtasks and they are more static that live inside the task itself. You can also add attachments and comments alike. Now if I zoom out of this, I can also move the task, copy it and copy the link to it. But as you can see, this is a task that I have here and it's been updated with pink. So you can give a little bit of an indication of the information. And over here, if I go to filters, I can even do things like narrow down to only pink showing or only put the backlog items that are showing. Of course, I have no backlog items, so that will not appear. You can also see who it's assigned to and also give an indication of what the urgent stuff on your list today, as well as the importance of due dates as well. You can have multiple filters at one time. Now over in the right hand corner, you can change stuff based on progress. You can change stuff based on who's it assigned to, and you can even move to priority level as well, which helps give you a better indication of tasks. And if I were to add a task here, it gives you a little tiny menu that allows you to add one much faster. In this case, I could add something like record video and press assign. And as you can see, it's automatically given it a indication of important. But if I wanted to change it, it will move to urgent. So any task you create from these board areas, the better, because it will naturally bring that through. Now you can also share this, as I said earlier, which is quite easy to do. And you can view this in multiple different views. My plans doesn't just extend to board. It allows you to see stuff in a grid view, which is much more of a list view, which allows you to see stuff like a table and allow you to narrow it down. If I clear them all, you can start to see how this populates and how this looks. And naturally, there's no way of grouping, but you can filter by a keyword if you're looking for something and the list is very, very long. Now up here, there's a really nice view called schedule. This is nice because if you want something that is reflective of calendar, but has this sort of upcoming list on the side, this is quite nice. For example, if you wanted the due date items that appear or who they're assigned to on the right hand side, this is great, but you can also drag items in, which means that if you've got something coming up, you can sort of assign it for the relevant days. And as you can see, those items that were red are going a different color, and that's because they're no longer out and overdue, which is perfect. So utilizing this can be a great way to organize some tasks and see what your week looks like. It's also a good way to see the general day view. It doesn't actually have exact timings, although I believe you can add that. You can't add that as part of it. However, this gives you an indication of more of a Kanban week planner view, which is quite helpful at the same time. You can also hide recurring tasks in the future, which is helpful just to take a little bit of weight out of what you've got. And finally, there's an area called charts. This is great if teams are working on this and you want to be able to see, okay, there's loads in backlog. Let's go and help the team out with that. There's too much in emergent and I can go and relax that team member or take some workload off them. And for example, you can see anything that a team members or what the team member does or doesn't have. This is great also here because you can add tasks and be able to coordinate them a bit more into the right locations. So obviously there's, for example, if I go to my plans, you can see the project management version of this is not vastly different, but obviously changes a few of the perspectives that you might have in terms of having you a sort of bit of a setup. You can create anything from a basic, which means that say I called this one plan one, I can go ahead and see that same structure, grid, board, schedule, and charts, which is all very helpful. Now, if I go to my tasks, anything that has been assigned to you, whether it's part of a project or not, you can bring them in. So for example, if I were to assign this to me and I would assign it to the start date to today and also the due date to today, you can start to see that these tasks will populate. They should populate. There you go, create a plan. And you can see here that because it's assigned to this date and it's part of this source, it will bring it in. And you can see which ones have been completed, as well as from here, you can narrow down the filtering as well. So that is New Planner as part of Microsoft 365. And it's very reminiscent of a combination of Project Planner and also Microsoft To Do. So it's interesting to see how Microsoft are combining task management in one location. Thank you very much for watching, but if you're in the hunt for a tool, jump over to Toolfinder, which will be linked here and below as well, so that you can find the perfect productivity tool for you, whether that be Microsoft or not. Anyway, folks, thank you so much for stopping by. If you want to watch more of these, press subscribe and we'll see you then. It's been Francesco D'Alessio here for Keep Productive, and I'll see you all very soon. Cheerio. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, you can check out another video here on YouTube diving into productivity tools. But if you did want to, you can jump over to Toolfinder to discover any productivity tools, which will be linked here as well. We have a resource of over 250 productivity tools and growing. And naturally, there are reviews, insights, and much more. So do check it out below. But thank you very much for watching this video.